name is Joe Field. I own Flying Colors Comics and Other Cool Stuff in Concord, California, and we've been here since 1988. Summer of 1967, which everyone considers to be the summer of love, for me became the summer of comics, because on the third day of summer, teaching a four-year-old how to climb trees, I fell out of one from about 25 feet, broke my arm in several places, and spent the night in the hospital. And when I got home and was ordered to stay in bed for a couple of days, friends brought me gifts, and one of my friends brought me two comic books. Well, comics are a unique visual medium because they're really the genesis of all visual media. If you think about TV shows or video games or advertising or movies or any other visual entertainment, they all begin with storyboards. They begin with pictures and sometimes narration, sometimes words that go along with it. But they're consecutive panel to panel storytelling in those other media with the storyboards to get to the finished product. Well, that's what comics are.
They got interested in the possibility of having comics here, and my chair, Christina Rudolo, was really enthusiastic about those options and having classes that are both sort of studies but also hands-on practice mixing, which is sort of the nature of the kinds of classes I teach. And that comics is certainly a very exciting thing right now, so I'm just really open to it. And we started classes a year and a half ago without the minor, and then started working towards it, and it was approved last December, and we were able to graduate 5 students completed the minor in this May. We talk a little bit of history, and then that's sort of interwoven through some of the various texts we read. I do a lot of theory. I mean, my work comes from theory of how the form works, and a theory in that way. So a lot of understanding how comics are not like animation or movies, but some of the overlaps with other mediums, but how they are their own distinct medium, and how that has some really powerful ways to tell stories and to convey meaning that other forms don't have. So I want them to really understand, I think we tend to have a view of comics as like sort of simpler versions of other things, and I'm really trying to educate them in the idea that no, comics do these things that can't exist in other forms.
I do primarily web comics, although I'm like working on a graphic novel right now. A lot of them are pretty long, a lot of them are pretty short, but I do the writing and art for all of it. Most of it's online, but I have printed a few books and sold them in like independent comic shops and bookshops in the city. As soon as I got out of college, I knew if I wasn't writing every day, then I wasn't doing my job. There was a teacher, like one of my first creative writing classes, that said the statistic. I don't remember the statistic, but she said that most creative writing students don't end up in a career of creative writing. And I kind of wanted to prove that wrong. So I was writing every day. And to do that efficiently, I needed to release something every day. And I decided I'll do comics because I can release it weekly and people will expect it. And I can also kind of learn as I go. So my first comic was kind of based on web comics I've read before, where it's kind of like minimal story and kind of an odd format, maybe just like a few panels on a page. But then I really started to learn about all these amazing web comics that have like really detailed stories and amazing like layouts and just like really underappreciated artists online. And so I really grew to love comics through that and decided to continue it after my first comic.